Guys, and welcome back to Air. So, let's just jump right back in. Did this bread have a bone to pick with me? Tona was still staring at my face. What? What's wrong with her?
Michiru.
It's late. Let's do it tomorrow.
But the bubbles! I was on a roll!
On a roll? If I remember correctly, she actually only managed to blow one. So I thought, but I didn't say it out loud.
I'll make a packed lunch for you.
Ooh, okay, will you make a hamburger steak for me?
Okay.
She nodded.
Really?
Yep.
Yeah!
Michiru was visibly delighted.
So, Kamiyo-san, we have to take our leave now.
Yes. It's time for us to go back too, right, Yukito-san?
Yeah, I was already hungry.
Well then, have a good summer break.
Okay.
Kunisaki-san too. Take good care of yourself.
Right. I had the feeling that somebody was glaring at me.
Bye-bye, Kamiyan! Have a safe trip home!
Kamiyan?
She was referring to Misuzu, it seemed. Then she said to me,
you can go die in a ditch or something.
Damn her.
Bye.
Good night.
In the twilight, the two girls' overlapping shadows gradually faded into the distance. My eyes reflexively followed the girls' silhouettes. Hey.
Yes?
Did I offend that brat?
I don't know.
It's kind of getting to me a bit.
Oh, yeah. You didn't draw the station on the map.
Oh, wait, whoops. Oh, yeah, you didn't draw the station on the map.
Yep, that station isn't operational anymore, so I thought there wasn't any need.
Not operational?
Yeah, for a while now, there haven't been any trains running.
Was there some accident?
No, they said it wasn't making money or something.
I see, a discontinued line. Then it was definitely impossible to go anywhere by train.
Do you want me to add it?
Wait, do you want me to add it? Oh, wait, that was supposed to be her. What?
The station! Should I add it?
Well, sure. It's a good landmark for when I'm walking around.
Okay, I'll draw it on.
Thanks.
No problem. Okay, let's go home.
Yeah. Walking together with Misuzu, I gazed up at the darkening summer sky far off into the horizon. Before I knew it, countless stars were shining above the borders of the hills. Is that the Milky Way? Across the expanse of the sky, the stars sang their twinkling songs of life. I turned my head to get a panoramic view. It was breathtaking. Without the clouded air of the city, here, I could see each and every star. Perhaps this was one of the simple pleasures that accompanied a journey. After eating dinner, I laid on the floor of the lounge watching TV. In front of me was the money note I held in one hand.
Yukito-san, don't keep looking at that. Come play cards!
Just take this and flee from this place? But no, I haven't taken back my tool of the trade yet. But then, can't I just buy a new puppet? Certainly, that one is quite old already. But there are a lot of memories there. It was the thing that, when the day of my success comes, I would wish to share my joy with. Filled with memories, filled with dreams.
And he's saying incomprehensible things, too.
I rolled around.
Hey, Yukito-san! C-A-R-D-S! I want to play cards! Once Yukito-san got money, he became strange. I don't like that.
When I got up, Misuzu, who had been playing cards by herself, had disappeared. Probably she's gone to take a bath? I've sweated a lot, which means I should have one too. But I had no energy for it. Too tired. I'm used to walking for long periods of time, so the tiredness is only of the mind. Oh well. The only person I'll meet is at the most Misuzu. That's okay. I pulled up the blanket to my stomach and turned to sleep again.
Ah, Yukito-san is already asleep. If he doesn't take a bath, he'll be smelly. He's asleep. Ah, doesn't seem to be too smelly. Where's the map? There. Update finished. I'll sleep as well. The Sloth-san puppet, where is it? I want to sleep with it. Oh, long leg is poking out of the bag. Got it. How come it seems as though the legs have stretched? Oh well, since it's cute, I'll borrow it for one night. Good night.
I had the feeling that I heard Misuzu's voice just then. Didn't know whether it was a dream or not. I went to sleep once again. The next time I opened my eyes, Haruko sat where Misuzu had been, chewing on a squid leg, pouring wine into a cup. In a haze, I kept on looking at that scene. After a while, I closed my eyes again. I recovered consciousness just before I suffocated and hurriedly spat out the stuff that was in my throat. Do you want to kill me? In front of me was Haruko. In her hand was the bottle. She had it tilted in preparation for pouring more into my mouth. Don't pretend to be asleep. I saw your eyes open. Even if that's true, there's no excuse for pouring wine into somebody else's mouth, right? And I'm tired. Let me rest. Hey, is our friendship only worth that much? That's no good. It's no good. I lied down again. No good. She repeated it as if it was some kind of spell, and then suddenly started to laugh strangely. Is it okay? If you don't pay attention to me, then it'll be this child who accompanies me for the night. Taking a look, she held my puppet in her hand and was playing with it. Here, let it rest. I took out the money note from my pocket and thrusted it at her. What is this? Haruko took it and squinted at it closely. Don't you know, it's a 1,000 or 10,000 yen note. This means I've bought your sloth. I'm going to sleep. Amazing! When you set your mind to it, you can do it. I see. Still, didn't seem ready to let me sleep. She was mumbling to herself. Hey, are you asleep already? Oh, there's no help for it. Let's make him drink again! This time she aimed the mouth of the bottle at my nostrils. Where are you trying to make me drink? I jumped up. You. I've already won the contest. Be nice and let me sleep. There wasn't any contest at all. Then you should even more just let me go to sleep quietly. Hey, I want to use you to play. It's interesting. It wasn't play with you, but use you to play. Okay, whatever. You guys get it. I can't speak today. I'm sleeping in the shed. I stood up. Hey, you. That really is no good. Nothing will happen if you accompany me for a bit. I already have to escort Misuzu in the mornings. If I have to accompany you at night, then when am I supposed to sleep? Then just don't sleep! Ignore. Just as I got to the hallway, Haruko started talking as if to herself. You're still going together with Misuzu in the mornings, eh? I see. What is it? Hey, I'll drink in my room so you can sleep here if you want. She grabbed the wine and accompaniments and stood up. Good night. To the last, she still had the squid leg in her mouth. I was left there alone. The place returned to total tranquility. Tonight should be uneventful. I somehow got by only having wine forcibly poured down my mouth, and a bottle pushed at my nostrils. I pulled my blankets up and rolled over. Come to think of it, my puppet. I opened my eyes and searched the floor. It had been placed on the spot where Haruko had sat. More accurately, it had been nicely sat on the cushion. I reached out and picked it up. Just had the feeling that it's been a while since I had it in hand. But there's something wrong with it. For some reason, it looked a size smaller. Plus, it was missing an eye. It's been in the wash. I could still smell the washing powder. Although it was only a short day, this fella had already suffered a lot of pain. I'm very sorry. I clapped my hands together and apologized to the puppet. Okay, July 22nd, Saturday. The next morning. Like always, I walked alongside Misuzu towards the school, but we had somewhere else to drop by today. Misuzu and I waited in front of the girl's house. Are you still in time for school?
Yep, there's still a little bit more time.
Misuzu had been hugging the soft toy all this while.
Here she is.
That little girl came out with her mother. I recalled that her name was pronounced Saika, although I didn't know her name was written in Japanese, or how her name was written in Japanese. The girl ran towards us. She headed straight for Misuzu. She didn't even glance at me.
Here!
Misuzu handed the girl the soft toy. Wait! I stopped her and touched the sloth. No, nothing.
Here!
Misuzu gave the soft toy to the girl. She hugged it and returned to her mother's side.
Bye-bye!
Misuzu waved at them. The girl and her mother also waved us goodbye.
That girl told me she escaped from the hospital.
Really? Did the girl tell her that on the way back yesterday?
But she said she'd be fine with that sloth by her side.
Why?
Because they're friends now.
I see.
So she's going to go back to the hospital with Mr. Sloth.
I see, that's nice.
Yukito-san, you're able to make children laugh.
I don't know about that.
I know you're able to inspire laughter, because you touched Mr. Sloth just now to make Saika happy, right?
No, it's not like that. The two faded into the distance. The sloth was waving at us from the girl's back. Misuzu waved back. Let's go, you'll be late for school.
Okay.
The ground was wet. Someone had splashed water on it. When the sun climbed higher, that mark on the ground would fade away. Summer was still ongoing. Does time mean anything to the sky? When I looked up, I saw the same sky as always. It was there all along, and it shall always be there henceforth. Up in the sky, there's a girl with wings. She has been there since long ago. She is there even now. In the same air, she continues to feel the wind with her widespread wings. I imagined her in my mind. It was a beautiful image. It was so beautiful, yet filled with sadness. I pulled my gaze back to the ground. I thought about the purpose of my journey. I wanted to find the girl that was still in the sky right now, but I hadn't decided what I'd do after I found her. I was just chasing the imagery my mother left me when I was still little. But in my imagery, the girl in the sky always looked sad. It was a dream filled with sadness. The sky was always a depressing blue. My other self is there. I get that feeling. If the girl in the sky were to come down to the earth, would she look like Misuzu? Misuzu.
Hmm?
Do you have wings?
Wings?
Yeah.
Of course not! Although, I think it'd be pretty cool to have wings.
I guess.
You say the strangest things.
She was right. The girl in the sky could not be Misuzu. Misuzu was so close to me, smiling at me. Then why did I think like that? I could not understand it myself.
Right on time.
I see.
I gotta go now.
As far as I knew, this was the first time she arrived at school on time. Misuzu turned around at the school gate and proudly showed me a V sign. You are expected to be on time, you know. She was the only one who was proud of not being late for school.
Let's play together when I get back.
play by yourself.
Then I won't concentrate in class.
Don't be selfish, I'm busy.
I want to have something to look forward to.
You know? Alright. Alright, I'll play with you. I had no choice but to give in to her. If I didn't do this, she'd refuse to go to school.
Really?
Yeah.
Then I should be able to concentrate in class today.
Hang in there.
Okay. What should we play later?
Just get going.
Huh? What did you say?
She didn't hear me. The wind was too strong. You're going to be late. The girl was already thinking about what to do in the afternoon. Hurry! I shouted at her. But the wind became even stronger and drowned out my voice. Misuzu was trying to keep her skirt from being flipped by the wind. I decided to wait for the wind to die down. When the wind stopped, I heard the final echoes of the chime.
What?
Forget it, just take your time.
Okay, wait for me.
Misuzu ran off. The one late for school was the only one who hadn't noticed the bell had rung. She passed the gates with quick steps.
Yukito-san, you're able to make children laugh.
Misuzu had told me that this morning. Is there something different about me? I looked at my hands. I made my puppet move. Nothing had changed. Why would Misuzu say something like that? But I shouldn't delve too deeply into what Misuzu said. Gah! Something hit me from behind. My view changed to that of the sky. The bones in my neck creaked with a terrible noise. Gah! The pain was so intense that for a while I was writhing in pain on the seawall.
Whoa! Sorry, I charged at you too fast!
I heard the voice of an anxious girl.
Pico pico!
Another bizarre voice joined in. Ugh. You too? What were you thinking?
It's sports array time!
The girl in the school uniform was making up some incoherent excuse. What the hell is that?
Pico pico pico! Sumo! That's right, it's sumo! Heave ho!
She pushed against my chest with both hands.
Heave ho! Heave ho!
She was probably trying to cover up for her mistake. She tried to push me out of the ring. Of course, there wasn't any ring here.
Pico pico pico!
Underfoot, the furball wagged its tail and cheered for the wrestlers. A sumo ring had opened up suddenly in the middle of nowhere. How thrilling!
Heave ho! Heave ho!
Retaliate! I knocked away the girl's hands.
Whoa!
My attacker lost her balance. I unleashed a barrage of sumo-like pushes at her.
Whoa!
She looked ready to run away. What a pushover. So I thought, but I was wrong. The girl steadied her stance and met my attacks with those of her own.
I won't lose!
It was a battle of endurance from here on out.
Heave ho! Pico pico pico! Pico pico pico!
I did not know the reason or the cause. But two humans and one dog was engaged in an epic battle on the seawall under the hot sun. My hands moved faster. I was planning to finish this.
Whoa!
The girl was backing off bit by bit.
Whoa!
The girl had stepped on the edge of the ring. Deliver the finishing push! I made the final push against the girl's chest. Boing! My hand was on something soft. What's this? Gotta check it. This is...
Whoa! You touched my boobs!
So I did.
Perv!
Gah! The next moment, I was sent flying through the air by her all-out push. I lost. The summer sky was blue, as far as the eye could see.
That was fun!
The girl was laughing in the wind.
Pico pico pico!
The strange dog was laughing as well. Hope you liked that. I picked myself up from the concrete ground while rubbing my sore buttocks. A sense of emptiness struck me when I thought about what I had been doing. So I changed the topic. But I am all out of time for this episode, guys, so if you liked it, please give it a big thumbs up down below. And I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye!